aim day. How are you feeling, Will?
Look, I don't know, I'm in a different time zone. No, I'm okay. Just want to just get there now. It's one of those things where you're just rushing to get to, even though we're early. We've got to get across the country, across the city. And especially we get there and get the bike set up and stuff. So we'll be good when we're on the start line. So give it an hour and we'll be ready to go. We'll just get geared up and ready to rock, really.
It's early morning, nearly 10 to 6, we're a bit late after all that preparation, but we're just heading now to taxis, get down to the start line, check the bike over, make sure we've got no burst inner tubes overnight, get in the water, check the temperature, have a little pre-swim, and then ready to go, all lock and loaded now.
Repping.
Game time, boys!
So Copenhagen, friends and family, a morning can be a little bit chilly, so sometimes you need to warm up your hands.
Boys did good in the swim. Brad absolutely smashed the swim. He did 107, which I think he was aiming for like 110, which was faster than what he'd gone before, so really good. Will and Mark, they came out about 125. Will be super happy with that. I think he just said under 130 it'd be great, 120 would be amazing, so in the middle. Not sure about Mark. I think he might have wanted to go a tiny bit faster, but you never know what like went on in the race kind of thing. And then I think Craig did pretty much exactly the same time, just slightly faster than his last Ironman, so good.
Saw everyone cheering, he was happy getting on his bike, about to cycle off and start his race, and then he swerved off and had an altercation and crashed.
So at the minute, the boys are on the bike. I think Brad's about halfway on the bike, so probably another 2.5-3 hours maybe. And then we're just making some signs to boost some morale on the course, get a little playlist ready, and just get some lunch and chill.
That's the best.
Yeah, it's 14 female.
Good pace. Happy with it. Catching all these big guys that went past me on the bike. Now I'm pulling them back in.
Woo!
Well done, well done.
How you feeling, Mark?
Oh, knackered, mate. Absolutely knackered.
We just see Mark. He looks all right. I think he's just finishing his third lap, maybe. And we're looking for Will. He looks like he's dropped off a little bit on his split, so I'm hoping he's had a bit of a toilet break. But he may be in a little pain hole, so we'll see. Hopefully there's some shade now, which will help them. But yeah, just going to see if he's all right, hopefully.
Playing hard now. Tough now. Not so cocky anymore. Yeah, it's hard with it now. Can't get any more gels in. Stomach's so tight. There's that many people injured on the course, limping. Just happy I can keep going. So, you know, last hour of running.
God, the music.
Take a breath, bro. Yeah. Breathe deep.
What? It's okay. Oh, God. I literally can't stop music. Mate, I'm fighting this, bro. I'm fighting really hard.
Yeah. Just catch your breath, man. Catch your breath.
I absolutely smashed us in the bike. It's the fastest I've ever done it. This, my head gasket's falling. I've just got to fight it. Yeah. Yeah. Mate, I'll tell you how many times I've been sick. I'm gonna stick if you find me.
I need a new pair of feet at the end of this. I can't feel my feet, but we're getting there. It's funny, I've actually felt stronger as I've been going round. The first lap was horrendous, I felt awful, but second, third lap, a lot stronger.
Come on, Will, keep going, you. Come on.
Come on, boy, you've got this.
How are you doing? I'm exhausted.
Hey?
I'm exhausted. Exhausted. I can't stop in six.
Get those big props. Cross the line. Come on, you go. Come on, you go. Move. One step for a little bit. Come on. I know.
Come
on.
So,
I know.
Come on.
I'm okay.
Come on. Just keep moving.
Go on, talk me through it. What are you feeling?
I just can't stop being sick. I've got absolutely nothing. Every time I start to run, I vomit.
Well, is this the hardest thing you've ever done?
Yeah. The last time I done this, and I spewed this much, I had 2 hours off in between. I've never felt this in my life. Never. I literally can't. I can't.
He's very ill, but he's finishing it. He will finish it, even if it kills him. So he's just gone past the 38k mark 2 minutes ago, which I think is just up this road. We're just going to wait for him, and we're going to walk with him back. We've got Gemma and Brad coming to meet us. Poor Brad, he's finished his, he smashed his Ironman, which is awesome. They're going to come and meet us, and we're going to walk back with him, and he's going to finish it.
Yeah, Yeah, Brad's finish was amazing. He wanted 11 hours. He got two punctures though.
So did he?
In, yeah, two punctures. Came in just after. But yeah, he's happy. Good. Amazing. Went to plan.
What have we got left, lads?
1.5k.
1.5k?
Until Mr. Foden becomes an Ironman. Here's them four magic words. I'm not going to say them. Save them for the carpet. Bragging rights for life.
I've got sodium poisoning. So I'm in the medical tent post. I've tried my best. I've got to make it.
It's endurance racing for you. Roll the dice every time you go out. You can be as prepared as you want. Anything can crop up. Flats, mechanicals, sodium poisoning.
We can make it through the night. With a little bit of luck, we can make it through the night. With a little bit of luck, we can make it through the night. With a little bit of luck.
Course.
Wow.
Just look at you. Make it four.